When we invite the demons out to play, we get more control of the darkness. Dictating darkness was never my goal, yet somehow here I am within the dungeon of immortal serpents. Where things go from here, only the wind knows. A chuckle and a laugh, and then the race begins as we ever wind along this healing journey, just trying to catch a glimpse of what our soul actually looks like. Painted colors we don't even know how to describe or define. This light is so much more miraculous than anyone could have anticipated. I'm not afraid of the darkness. The darkness is my friend. We've been acquainted long before I even knew what life was. The depths of the darkness that terrify you are the reality I've only ever known. Exploring the wicked, wretched cracks of the soul was never on my to-do list, and yet here I am doing it, listing all the ways my insanity holds me back, unable to change it. Yet changing is what I'm doing, evolving, transforming, expanding, evolving. Did I say evolving? Because, hey, I'm evolving. I'm over here growing wings where once were thorns. I'm over here hanging my banner of light where once my chains just bound me to the ground. But now I am flying, spinning circles around, dancing in the starlights of the skies the fairies only ever knew. The softness of rose petals touched upon lips, tender moments. This is what we've been waiting for, and yet we're terrified. We're too scared of intimacy. We're too scared of connection. We're too scared of vulnerability. We're too scared of authenticity. And yet here we are trapped together alone. It makes no sense. Yet somehow everything makes sense. The moment we decide, it doesn't have to make sense. The artistry of our existence is what we're here to explore, expressing through the arts. The poetry of our lives is what we are here to share, transform, evolve. Did I say evolve? Because, hey, we're over here evolving. As we express ourselves, we are shedding layers, generations of insanity, generations of trauma, generations of holding back. We are shedding skins, shedding limiting beliefs. We are over here shedding. We're evolving. Did I say evolving? Because, hey, we're over here evolving. Wrapped up in the magic of it all. Dancing in the glories of our imagination. Nothing has to make sense. There are no words. Words are unnecessary in this moment of perfection, this imperfect perfection that transforms pain into light, that transforms darkness into light, that transforms our past into a future. Hey, what's up? I'm evolving. I'm over here writing a story, an epic story created in each moment of every day. I'm given choices, millions of choices. What thought to think, what feeling to focus on, to let go, to hang on, to forgive and let go, or do I keep remembering this insanity over and over? Do I cling to this righteous indignation, or do I shed my bitterness? How do I go forward from here? I'm over here writing the story, the poetic story of my existence. In each moment of every day, we are creating the storybook that will be left behind for all eternity. We have just this one fleeting life, and yet it is connected to every other infinite life. We are all one. As I write my story, I try to help others write their stories. They reach over to adjust a little mark on my page while I applaud the marks on theirs. We're all here growing, evolving, transforming, expanding, healing together. The story is not just mine, don't you see? It is the story of every living creature. My story is not mine. It is the world's. It is the story of life. It is the story of yin-yang, of light and dark, of feminine and masculine energies swirling together. My story is not just mine, and thank goodness it's too big for me. I'm too small for this. I'm so glad I'm not alone in my story. I'm so glad there are different colors of ink and different handwritings all across my pages. I'm so glad my book is worn from the people who have explored my story, even if they didn't stay. I'm so grateful for the ability to lose time as I get wrapped up in exploring the artistry of my own existence, experiencing magic in every moment that brings me to tears of ecstasy and elation. Yes, the sorrows are there, but I choose not to focus. What you focus on grows, and I know I'm growing a worthwhile garden. It is so beautiful, you can smell the roses for miles.